Oh my God, please, please be Verity.
Welcome back everyone to the third installment of this mesmerizing third attempt at a straight line across Wales. You rejoin me and Ben slap bang in the middle of Wales, having battled our way through 16 and a half miles of farmland. Just hours earlier, we escaped a horrendous ordeal with a furious Welsh farmer by the narrowest of margins, only for me to sprain my ankle an hour later through sheer exhaustion. With most of the farmland done and dusted, and nothing ahead of us now but wild and rugged moorlands and forests, we were supposed to be celebrating at this point. But that wasn't really the case. My ankle, which had already become quite swollen and painful, simply could not afford to be any worse in the morning. And after a very cramped night's sleep in the car, it was time for the verdict.
Not great. Not great, but I think I can do it.
Did you take two of those?
Oh yeah, it's not good. The pain I can take, but it's the being unstable, going down something steep. That's what I don't like.
I'd sure as hell have to be careful, but it was workable. And after a few minutes and a couple of new offends,
time to go.
Today was all about crossing the reservoir and getting as far into the moors as we could. If the ankle was all right and we could make it to camp 3 by dark, then we could really start to celebrate. But with a kayak on my shoulder, a bad ankle and a mile of farmland between us and the reservoir,
thanks Verity.
Ah, that seemed a long way off.
Ready? Yep. See ya. Oh, she's gone. This is going to be one of the hardest bits. This leg down to the reservoir, there's still threat of getting caught by farmers. It's Monday morning now, and we've got, as you can see, a lot to carry.
It wasn't an easy mile by any stretch. It was slow and awkward and taxing on pretty much every muscle. But with a bit of help from Ben at the fences and a bit of luck with the farmers, we were getting there. While we did so, Verity was making her way round to the other side of the reservoir, where later on she would play an important role in helping us cross it. Back on land though, me and Ben ended up having to carry our heavy loads through what I originally thought was some sort of water station, but was actually someone's dodgy, overgrown property. Thankfully though, we were able to slip silently through.
That was a bit gnarly, wasn't it? That was a bit gnar gnar. Fucking hell. That is a big bull, isn't it? Nope. Fuck, that killed me.
We're doing good.
We crossed this successfully.
Yeah, we're doing really well, aren't we?
We're doing really well.
We're on course.
Yeah.
Hey, there's a rainbow for everyone.
As the rainbow's flawless frame grew bolder, so did our hopeful shadows, who flung themselves westward towards the heartening horizon and the calm waters of the reservoir.
God, it's quite amazing. Oh, safe and sound.
I fucking get here now!
The reservoir's water levels were low and its banks big and steep. I probably should have been fully concentrating on not further injuring my ankle, but I couldn't help gush with unshakable optimism and joy at our situation.
I love the next day after a low point. Sun out, rainbow in the sky, and the feeling that everything's coming your way. How are you feeling, Ben?
Better.
It's a real feeling now that, like, I can succeed this trip. Early this morning when I was lying in the car, my foot was hurting. I was 90% sure that we were just gonna call it a day and maybe come back another day and finish it, but I just feel like it's possible now.
Whoa,
that was steep.
Okay, good.
Just brilliant. In time for the rain.
Just in time for the rain. At least the water's calm.
I
Okay. Should we get to work?
Yeah.
That's going up.
Don't let me float off.
Whoa.
Yeah, she was cast off?
Yeah.
Okay, just be steady, be balanced. Take it really steady. Because quite honestly, I don't know if I'd float with this tiny life jacket. God, that's nothing, is it? Mm-hmm. We're done. Soo! Job done, man. Crossing one done.
Things were going smoothly for us, but the same couldn't be said for Verity, who was having a desperate time trying to get to the shoreline on the route that I'd planned for her. With no actual paths down to the lake and no reliable phone signal, we just had to trust that she was able to find her way down one of these gullies, which admittedly weren't quite what I thought they were, and hope that she popped out somewhere along the shoreline, not wanting to kill me.
Are you there?
Okay, good.
Yes.
The things you do.
Oh my God, your hair. Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
You didn't do that for me.
Of course I would.
As Verity guided the kayak round the lovely spacious coast, we headed into the pine.
Oh, jeez. Okay, let's do it.
The forest was dense, wet, and made worse by brambles.
Greg, you're not missing out on much, mate.
But as we were actually wearing ripstop military-grade clothing, we were soon on the shore again.
Hello, hello, hello.
Here we rejoined Verity and the boat.
Hello.
And even if I did fail to film it, we then completed the second leg of the paddle.
Oh, okay. That didn't seem to have filmed, or at least the latter half of it. Yeah, we successfully paddled round the edge of that thing, deviating only a few metres. Verity walked round. We're out just about. We got up this steep, muddy bank. The rain is horrible. We're going to get some shelter, but that is the paddling done. Nice one, Ben. Nice one, Verity. Yeah. She is not a happy girlfriend. Okay, let's go. Lots to do today.
We'd be up on the moors soon, where most of today's work would be done, but there was a fair bit of forest to get through first. Stashing the kayak near the shore, we once again said our goodbyes to Verity, who went off in search of a slightly easier exit, and gladly entered the much loftier, more palatial pine that remained.
I think my ankle is holding out, but straight away, look how quickly things can change. All of a sudden, you're faced with slippery logs. One slip with my ankle and, oh, could be game over.
A few moments later, we were faced with another worryingly slippery obstacle.
Yeah, that's shoes off job, mate.
And it turns out we weren't the only ones who had to cross it.
Verity! That's mental.
Opting to keep our feet dry for the sake of one little river, we went barefoot.
Oh, fuck, that's so slippy.
A risky strategy for my ankle, but once we were out and eventually laced up again, we could continue on with dry feet. For about 60 yards.
You're kidding.
Honestly,
right, hang on.
Getting out of wits in. Really am.
Really?
Yeah.
I might just do it with my shoes, mate. Just get there and leap. I can't be bothered, mate, to take my shoes off.
But again, we figured for the sake of one more little river, we might as well just keep our feet dry.
Okay, I better fucking be the last one. No, no.
No.
No! How? Why do we put our shoes on again?
Reckon we can get across that?
Try it. Fucking try it, mate. Let's do it, it'll be funny. I think you've got about a 25% chance of success. And me even less. Fucking hell, man.
Oh, God. Okay, I'm just going to jump.
Are you? No, just balance.
No.
Oh, God.
Having endured this whole charade for absolutely nothing, Ben was surely hoping I'd be joining him in the wet feet club.
Whoa. I know.
Whoa.
Oh, not bad.
Hey, that's not too bad. All of that was for nothing. For Ben.
Oh,
sorry.
But for Ben, it was about to get worse.
Oh! Oh! Oh, fuck it out. Oh, sorry, Ben. But that is hilarious.
I am never doing this ever again.
Mate, think of the pub meal at the end.
Sort that
out. Gladly for Ben, that was the last river crossing, and we'd soon be leaving this unforgettable forest. However, there were two or three farmers' fields that led up to the open moorland, and as you can imagine, we were extremely eager to get beyond them.
Okay, march quick. This is tough. I'm physically hurting, but also I'm shitting myself. The idea of being caught here doesn't bear thinking about, quite frankly.
It was slap bang in the middle of these stressful moments that another problem surfaced.
Sorry?
Battery's low.
Okay. Just go.
It seemed like a fairly innocuous one at first, but I quickly realised that something was a bit off.
Don't worry, the batteries won't run out.
Is it?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Usually the batteries for the GPS will last 1.5, maybe 2 days of solid missioning. These batteries had run out after just 3 hours. That struck me as odd, especially with how suddenly the screen turned off. But we put it down to a damaged or mixed up pair of batteries and replaced them with one of the two spare pairs we had in our tech box.
Thank fuck.
We were now past the worst of the fields and climbing higher and higher towards freedom. Each boundary signifying an undeniable upgrade in welcomeness, until we found ourselves in areas that even the grumpiest of farmers would leave you to stroll through in peace.
Yeah, that is where we've come from.
This is good, we're in a good place. Touch wood.
Hurting from our latest hefty climb, we treated ourselves with a small sugar break and a quick glance at our exact position.
To camp 3, we have 10 kilometres, so 6 miles. So, yeah, we've done 3.5.
Camp 3, wild, remote, and now only 6 miles to our west, had become almost like a finish line in our minds. Beyond it was 5.7 mostly downhill miles, and then the Duffy Estuary. So you can imagine how excited we were by the prospect of reaching it today, especially after everything we've been through.
Nice. Really enjoying this now, I won't lie. We're making good ground. We're getting the sense that today is doable. The sun's out, so we're drying off. The promise of things like fern and God knows what other obstacles will slow us down inevitably, but we've made enough ground now, about 4.5 miles, that we've set ourselves up for success, really, hopefully.
Of course, as in most of my episodes, things would start to go wrong quite soon, but before they do, let me quickly explain how things were supposed to go over at Camp 3. You see, we weren't the only ones with a bit of a trek. Verity would set off in the rental car from her Llanidloes base sometime around mid-afternoon, drive her way up to this point on this incredibly remote track, and trek the 2 remaining uphill miles, rucksack on back, to the lakeside camp spot. The main reason for this rendezvous was buoyancy aids for the short swim across the reservoir, as well as the usual stuff. Little did we know that we'd end up depending on Verity for so much more than flotation and a change of pants.
Wow.
Oh my God.
That's a beast.
You see, as we were taking our time, admiring the waterfall and clambering our leisurely way up our latest patch of ferns, the GPS system was slowly draining our second pair of batteries. And unbeknown to us, the very beating heart of our expedition was slowly dying in our hands. It would take some time for us to realize the true gravity of the situation, so for now, we can only watch on as we tackle our next obstacle, which coincidentally, I almost slowly died in the year before.
There's a pond over there, look.
Shit, mate. We go through that?
A pond right on our line.
Oh, you're kidding.
Mate, I'm not doing it again.
Nah, fuck that.
Look at all the... When you get all the slime in there, it means that on the floor, it's just mud. Slimy mud.
That's death, mate.
We'll go round, thank you. Hope you don't mind.
He's learning.
It's all right, doable. Stand on the big top.
Oh, God, my foot went straight in. Oh, no, I'm soaking.
Really?
Yeah. How are you not soaking?
I'm just used to the tufts, mate.
Used to the tufts.
I'm at one with the tufts.
And unfortunately for Ben, the awkwardly positioned death ponds continued.
Can we go that way? Are we really to the right?
No. We're already
okay,
about
10
metres.
Okay.
Oh dear.
Okay.
Whoa!
Boy, Bling! Yeah. Okay, you have to hold on to him.
Yeah. Okay. Into the woods.
Green, slimy, and wildly frustrating at the best of times, it was in this forest that we noticed the battery had gone down again. As counterintuitive as it was for myself, we needed to pick up the pace a bit.
This forest is over, and I think it's a good few miles of that.
Let's fucking march over this.
Run.
Yeah.
Oh mate, it's gone off. Right, get the last two batteries out and hope that they're good and do their job. We fucking need them to. Otherwise, Verity will have to come to this lake somehow. And yeah, I mean, there is a track, I can see a track, and we'd have to camp here. Okay, it's on. Yeah, I'll keep a close eye on it, that's all I can say. And the thing is, over there is absolute fucking middle of nowhere. Oh, wet. This is pretty brutal, this. This is about the worst terrain possible for my ankle. But I'm hanging in there, because I can smell the victory. It's very faint, but I can smell it.
Despite the probable lack of phone signal in this area, what we could have done was at least try to call Verity and see if she could scrap plan A and somehow make it to this reservoir instead. It would have been a lot to ask of her though, especially as I had no idea how far she could go in the car and how far she'd subsequently have to walk. Also, unlike with plan A, which was mapped out for her on the old GPS system, which I was starting to wish me and Ben had, there would be no reliable way for her to navigate to this reservoir, making it quite likely that she'd get lost, or at the very least, have to endure another stressful ordeal. Most crucially though, I think, I was now fairly sure that our third set of batteries were finally doing their job.
Still full bar. I'm pretty confident we can gamble a bit and soldier on.
So we soldiered tenaciously on into some of the most remote areas of the whole expedition.
Approaching the highest point.
Are we? Brilliant. Highest point of the trip, 529 metres.
We're here.
Here we are.
With the battery still full and the sun starting to poke out, we even began to enjoy ourselves again.
Oh, look at that. I feel like we've been given a full spa treatment today.
but it was short-lived.
That's it?
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Just about to film this rainbow, Ben turns round and says, the GPS system has gone down a bar already. I still think that's quicker than usual, abnormally quick. So all the more reason to keep marching, but I think we've only got about 3 or so miles now to get to Verity's spot, so I think we'll be okay. Because even if Verity has to march along the line, which she has on the backup GPS for a bit, it's not the end of the world. Depends how far it is.
But there was another problem.
Okay, I've just tried to ring Verity, presuming that up here, 500 meters above sea level, there would definitely be signal, and there wasn't. I guess because we're surrounded by other mountains. And that is a worry because this is pretty much the time where I would say to Verity, set off for your hour drive to make it to camp 3. If the GPS does die on us, we need to be able to contact her to tell her to walk towards us down the line with more batteries. So at the moment we're just gonna plow on and just make as much ground as we can. Oh, it's a big bog. Yeah, that's bad, man.
Get up, get up.
Mate, we can't go in there, that's a peat bog. Let's see the line.
We're to the right.
Fuck, all right, let's try and bridge that gap, but that'll be bad. It might not be as bad. I'll go first. It's bad. Let me try on these heathers. Okay. It's gonna go in your shoes.
Yeah, just go.
So we're not gonna drown in it. That's the good news. I'm hoping that's all right over there. Fuck. Fucking hell, man. Bad memories.
Oh God.
Let's hope there's not many more of them, mate. Our good old friend Pete. Another unforeseen obstacle. An inevitable unforeseen obstacle. That's what these missions are.
But there was more bad news. Take a guess.
Really bad news. The GPS has gone down another bar. So there's only 2 left. This is not good. Not good at all. It's actually really touch and go. We're basically having to fucking march now through heather and marsh, which isn't good, but the implications of this thing running out is much worse. So we are going quick. Why? Why do things go wrong when they're not meant to go wrong?
Desperate to get in contact with Verity, I scrambled for my phone to check for signal, and miraculously, we had some.
Hello? Okay, there's been a development at our end. We've got no batteries for the GPS. It's been absolutely eating through them like nobody's business. So we're gonna soldier as fast as we can. We're about 3 miles away. But if it runs out, you are gonna have to walk to us along the line. There's no other way, I'm afraid. It's not that bad, the terrain. It's like heather, marshy grass. It wouldn't be very nice, but there's no alternative. Okay, bye.
So, with half of our rapidly depleting battery now left, we absolutely powered our way through the uneven, energy-zapping, ankle-destroying tufts of marshland that stretched for miles ahead of us. The thing is, though, it didn't. There was a lot of marshy grassland between us and the camp spot, but there was also a huge forest as well. The biggest forest of the whole trip, in fact, and one that had a steep ravine in it too. The steepest ravine of the whole trip, in fact. I thought the big forest with its short, nasty trees was just after Camp 3, and that the forest that lay just over the next hill was relatively small. We can simply power through its big, spacious trees, pop out on today's final stretch of moorland and intercept Verity. That was a fantasy, of course, and back in the real world, our final pair of batteries were being rinsed at an unprecedented rate.
How many bars? Two. One. Fucking hell. Fuck's sake. Ah, what a piece of shit. This is bad. Okay, we've just had batteries low, literally 100 yards after it went down to one. It's fucking desperate. What a fucking... How can you predict this shit? I'll update you. The weather's quite bad, so the GoPro's playing up as well.
A few hundred painful yards later, with the forest, which I still believe to be the small one at this point, now in view, I tried to reach Verity again, but this time she had no signal, as she was probably driving. Very aware that this was probably our last chance for signal, but also that every second spent standing still meant more distance for Verity to potentially hike, I hurriedly sent her a text telling her that we were approaching Camp 3B, a marker I'd put on both of our GPS systems that signified a camp spot we could use had we not made such good progress. We then immediately marched on, faster than ever, into the woods, where the situation really started to feel desperate.
Yeah, this is the spot. The question is, how the hell is Verity going to get here? Did she get my texts? So we've done so fucking well today.
And that clip right there, ladies and gentlemen, is the last piece of footage I took until this one.
I don't know what to say right now. I have absolutely no words. This day has been an absolute disaster. If she's gone to look for me and something's happened, I will never, ever, ever, ever forgive myself. Why the fuck don't we have a satellite phone?
Why? How the... What happened there? All will be explained. The reason there is such a big gap in the footage is the GoPro... Well, apart from the desperate situation that was unfolding, my GoPro continued to have issues. It happens when it's cold and wet, and it just... Certain batteries won't work. It plays up, and we just didn't have time, as you can imagine, to mess about with the GoPro. I just consided to the fact, look, I'm just going to have to tell the story of what happened afterwards. So here is the story. Okay, here we go, guys. We're on the webcam now because, funnily enough, the GoPro couldn't handle taking a 5-minute video. So here we go. It's going to be massively condensed, this story. It's a minimum 15-minute story by rights, and it will be on the line review video, which I urge you to watch. But for now, it's a condensed version of what the hell happened here. How did we end up in that situation? Here we go. It starts with us, of course, entering this forest, as you saw, went through this rogue field, and then into this forest. Well, you can see, that is the moment, the inevitable moment, where the GPS screen went blank and left us in this dense... Oh, this forest was dense. It was small trees. We were barging through it. There was twigs to the face, smacking us in the face. But it was no use. It turned off and we were left in this little valley with no signal, of course. So what does this mean? Well, it means we're stuffed. We're fucked. Verity's last instructions are to head towards us. I now know that this is not the forest I thought it was. It's dense, it's horrendous, all of this is dense, and there's ravines to come. It very quickly dawned on us that despite there being a path just here, which you could pitch a tent on, that we can't stay here. We have to leave the line, get up onto some higher ground, and get signal to ring Verity to tell her to stay where the hell she is. But do not fear, guys, don't despair. This is not necessarily going to be a failure. And this whole debate about purity of line, leaving it and coming back to that spot, will be discussed later on. But just bear in mind for now, we do leave the line to camp sometimes, 20 metres, 30 metres, to collect firewood, to do our business, do poos, all right? We will resume this at the end of episode 4. Save your well-constructed arguments and comments for then. For now, what the hell happened here? Right, let's get the path tool out then so I can show you where me and Ben went. We backtracked back to the path momentarily. Can you go back along the line? I don't even know the rules anymore. We went up here onto this path, up onto higher ground, and then we went round here and just went up the hill where I got some bars. Rang Verity, told her, stay there, we will now come to you. Because that's the plan now. We have to get to Verity's car, sleep there the night, and return to that spot in the morning. That's all we can do at this point. Because we didn't have a satellite phone. I know! Twat! And I should point out at this point, it's only 3 p.m. There's still about 2.5 hours of daylight left. We've done remarkably well. We've made amazing progress, annoyingly. We would have been at the camp by, you know, 4, celebrating. Doesn't bear thinking about. It wasn't to be. Uncontrollable circumstances meant that we were in this position. But my point is, there's hours of daylight left for us to safely get to Verity. Yeah. Now, there's two things we could have done. We could have tried to just head west across these dense forests and ravines and out onto the moors. But we decided, no, paths is now the way forward. Let's get back down here. Let's follow these lovely, fast-moving paths, which will, of course, lead to where we want to go. That's what paths do. That's not how it panned out, guys. And I am going to, because I haven't got time to explain every decision we made, I'm just going to draw out the path that me and Ben took. And it really does pain me to draw this line without being able to fully justify and explain every little decision that we made, or rather I made, because I was navigating. But all I can say to you is, I completely underestimated just how disorientated you can get without a map, without a GPS, of course, without a compass, without the sun. The sun would have been useful. This place is really remote. I couldn't believe how remote this whole area was. I've seen a lot of whales, but this was really out in the sticks. And I got complacent. And all of a sudden, that would have been the right way, by the way, out there and across. But I, for some reason, decided it was wrong. But yeah, I'm starting to ramble again now. So I'm just going to draw this line and let you all just have a good laugh. Look at this. So embarrassing. GeoWizard my arse. But yeah, I was completely disorientated. And what ensued was just a huge ordeal. Our bodies were fucked at this point. We were low on sugar. My ankle was hurting, although it was quite numb at this point. And it was just one of the most physically demanding things I've ever done, because darkness was approaching. We were having to march. It was just never ending. We were sort of going, you know, in the right direction at this point, but at no point were we really in control. And the paths were really not our friend. This one included, big sweeping bend to the left. A really, really low point. Because at this point, darkness is falling. I'm starting to really worry about Verity at this point. That's the main thing that's driving me on at such speeds. I'm thinking the worst, which is that Verity is thinking the worst. And that she's in a flap and that she's gone out to look for us. Unlikely, I know. But just the idea that she might have gone out to search for us because she's convinced something's happened. And then her hurting herself was just... it was consuming me because it was all my fault. It would all be my fault. It's all made worse when we're unquestionably heading in the wrong direction. And at that point, I almost break down into tears. Genuinely, it was hopeless. I didn't know what to do. Ben, we're going the wrong way. How is this happening? But it was Ben, voice of reason, who said, Tom, we're bound to reach the road. We're going in a sort of circle here. We're bound to reach the road that Verity's driven on. And I said, you're right, Ben. And it was at this junction here, this lovely acute junction. A good old acute junction can change everything. And it did. And I knew then that we were on the right track. We split up there, which sounds like a dodgy decision, but I'll explain. All will be explained properly in the line review video. And it was at around this point here, in the pitch black at this point, after almost 10 miles of non-stop marching. That's since we left the line. That's not including the line. Marching on gravel tracks and off-road, up and down hills, that finally this footage was taken.
Oh my God. Oh my God. There. Please. Please be Verity. It's her, I think. I hope.
Okay, where are we going?
We're going back to the fucking,
hostel. Whatever it is.
We'd finally found Verity, who to my surprise was reading a book when she saw my headlight in the distance, so it was relieving to discover how calm and composed she'd remained. Me and Ben, on the other hand, were mentally and physically exhausted and in serious need of recovery. So it was a bittersweet journey back to base where we could begin our recuperation.
I don't know what to say to them. I mean, I can show them something.
We'll just start showing you. God. Oh my God.
The richest purple.
Our bodies simply weren't ready to go back first thing in the morning after a 6-hour sleep, so we had to spend the next day recuperating. During this time, I came to a bit of a realization. We might have failed to complete the line in one continuous, uninterrupted movement, which is what I always strive to do, but as long as we did return to the exact spot that we left it, we could still technically complete it. Despite what I may have said after my second attempt with Greg, it doesn't have to be a huge fail if you leave the line due to unforeseeable circumstances. It just makes it a lot less pure of a success than it otherwise might have been. With that in mind, Ben and I dusted ourselves down and prepared ourselves for our final assault.
William Bridgewater.
Armed with 36 AA batteries, we headed boldly back to the scene of our ghastly ordeal, determined as ever to blitz our way to the coast. If we could do so, it might not be the purest of victories, but it would still be a victory in our eyes. All that stood in our way was 6 more miles of obstacle-laden land, and I can confirm that whatever the ultimate outcome may be, you wonderful viewers won't be disappointed by the shenanigans of the final day of this unforgettable mission.
Come on, Ben, let's do it.
Fucking hell.
Oh my God.
Probably the worst thing I've ever been through.